Hello students, today we are going to discuss oral communication. Let us define oral communication. Oral communication is the process of verbally transmitting information and ideas from one individual or group to another. It can be either formal or informal. It's a direct method of communication. And a personal contact is established in such kind of communication. Oral communication is a word-based communication system. It is being found out that an executive spends 60 to 90% of the time talking to people in an organization. Face-to-face conversations, group discussions, counseling, interview, radio, television, telephone calls, etc. is used to express meaning in oral communication. Oral communication is very useful in motivating people, in persuading, in convincing, especially in business communication. It is very much flexible in nature. Why it is being said so? Because you can adjust the message according to the listener. First, you need to understand the needs of the listener. Who is in front of you? And what is the purpose of your communication? If you understand these two points very clearly, you can adjust the contents of your speech and messages accordingly. And this will lead to successful communication. Therefore, it has been said that oral communication is very much flexible in nature. It is fast, less expensive, and suitable for confidential and emergent talks. Oral communication has a very important place in our daily lives. Right from the morning till evening, we meet different people at different times, at different places, and different situations. And meeting people means talking, and hence oral communication takes place. Communication, especially oral communication, occurs within ourselves also, in our own thoughts. We speak to ourselves. Then we need to talk with our family members, our friends, our colleagues, seniors, juniors, people whom we meet outside, both socially and professionally. Let us discuss some of the different forms of oral communication. The first one is intrapersonal communication. Intrapersonal communication, just now I have said the kind of communication which takes place within ourselves. When we talk to ourselves in our thoughts, that is called intrapersonal communication. Examples, soliloquies in dramas are an example of intrapersonal communication. Interpersonal. Interpersonal communication is the communication that takes place between two people. Then small group, you understand? Examples are like classroom communication or the communication that takes place in small clubs. Then public communication, mass communication. Mass means a huge number of people. Mass communication usually takes place through the different platforms like television, print media, radio, etc. Corporate communication. This is the formal kind of communication that takes place in an organization. Then intercultural communication. People belonging to two different backgrounds or people belonging to this in the same background of culture, when communication takes place in such kind of people, it's said intercultural communication. Principles of oral communication. Clear pronunciation of message is very important factor in oral communication. If the pronunciation is not clear, the goal of the message will not be achieved. Before communicating orally, the speaker must take preparation both physically and mentally. There must be unity and integration of the speech. Otherwise, the sender is going to speak the last part first and the first part which is supposed to speak at the end. Therefore, unity and integration of the message is very much required. Precision. Precision is needed to make oral communication effective. The meaning of the words must be specific so that the listener can understand properly whatever the message is conveyed. The speakers must not fluctuate at the time of oral communication. He or she should always maintain a natural voice. Organized plan. It is very much necessary for effective oral communication. Then simplicity. The speaker should use simple, understandable words. High-flown words should be avoided because it can lead to a lot of confusion in getting the real meaning of the words. Therefore, words which are very easy and simple to understand should be used more in oral communication. Legality. The speaker's speech should be legal and logical at the time of oral communication. Excessive emotions can divert a speaker from main subject. Therefore, whenever the speaker is going through a disturbed emotional state, either he is too much excited in happiness or too sad or disturbed over something, it is best to avoid oral communication regarding important matters because it is very likely that the message might get distorted and even the listener might not understand the message properly. So we should understand that the speech must be emotionless. So when only we are in a stable emotional state, we should take care to communicate with others. Many people lose concentration after listening for a few minutes. For this reason also, speech must be emotionless. Speaker's efficiency and skill is necessary for effective oral communication. And once again, it has been stressed that the speaker should use the most familiar words to the receiver of the message to avoid any confusion in the meaning of the words. We have already discussed one point that oral communication is very, very much flexible. Here also, it's the same thing. We should pay attention to who the listener is, what is his capacity of understanding. And accordingly, we should use words so that it doesn't lead to any confusion in the meaning of the words. That's all for today. Thank you.